Hey guys, it's Alan, and this is the final video for my Rube Goldberg machine. So this week, I have thrown away my idea of the expo and decided to use a swing football along with dominoes to complete the transition from steps 10 to 11. So I will now be explaining what simple machines that I have used in my Rube Goldberg machine. So this is an overall course of my Rube Goldberg machine. So for steps 1 and 2, when the ball rolls down the ramp and hits the book, the ramp is an inclined plane, and when step 3 occurs, the book falls and propels the ball towards the wood. The falling book is a lever, and for step 4, when the ball on the other end hits the dominoes are levers, thus creating an inclined plane, the ramp, so that the ball could follow the track set up before it. There are no simple machines used in step 6 because it's only the ball rolling for a distance. And for step 7, when the ball falls into a hoop, it will then on roll down a ramp, which is another inclined plane, and hit a book, thus creating an domino effect on the other books. So dominoes, again, levers. From steps 8 to 10, the books are all levers because they're somewhat like dominoes. But when it reaches step 11, when the football hits the cabinet, I would say that the swaying football would kind of be categorized as a pulley because it's attached to a wedge on top of the roof, so I would say that it categorizes as a pulley. I don't think there's any simple machines used in steps 12 and 13 because it mainly relies on the vibration of the cabinet. Step 14, the ball rolls down the track because of the vibration. So the track is an inclined plane that leads the ball towards the light. Yes! No! So, for the energy diagram, the kinetic energy is marked in red, gravitational potential energy is marked in blue, heat energy in black, and the pencil dotted lines represent a reset in the gravitational potential energy as we reach a different system and different things are falling at different places, different heights, etc. Another important thing I want to mention is for steps 10 to 12, the lines are not straight because the swing football is dangling from up and down and up back again. So I marked the gravitational potential energy as a curvy line. So, for the calculation of the falling book. The book is 0.5 kg, and it takes 0.74 seconds for it to fall down. Now we add that into the equation, and then times it by 9.8 meters per second squared, and then divide it by 0.05 seconds. And then we get our answer, which is 72 newtons. So now we calculate the pressure on the ping pong ball. First, we have to find out the place of contact with the ball and the book. The ball's diameter is 40 millimeters, so we translate that into 0.04 meters. And then we divide it by 10, and then we score it, and we get the contact with the ball and the book. And then we get our previous answer from the following book's newtons, and then we divide it by 0.000016 meters times meters, which is the contact of the ball and the book, to get 450 kilopascals. So now we calculate the work done from the golf ball to the book. Now we know that the book's length is 13 centimeters, so we translate that into 0.13 meters, and then we times it by 2, because we want to think it of a circle. So we times it by 2 and we get its diameter, and then we divide it by 4 because we're only using 90 degrees of the 360 degrees, and then we get the distance from the tip of the book to when it falls down, and then we get 0.2041 meters. And then we get our previous answer for the falling book's newtons, which is 7.2 newtons, and then we times it by 0.2041 and get the work done, which is 1.46952. So I believe that my paperclip is a perfect indication of friction in my Rube Goldberg machine. The paperclip stabilizes the ball and allows it to not roll off the ramp. But as long as you apply a little force onto it or onto the cabinet so that it vibrates, the ball will roll over the paperclip and it rolls down the ramp. But while it does so, the paperclip will decrease its speed so that the ball doesn't roll off course or fall down or anything. So, change of direction. In this case, if you are standing across from the falling book, you would see the book falling towards you, and then the ball would move to your right. So it's 180 to 90 degrees. And second, the ball and the dominoes. So if you're standing in this position, you would see that the ball moves to your right, and then the dominoes transfers that direction of energy, something from the right to something that moves forwards. And next, the falling ball. So if you're standing in the position of the ramp, you would see that the ball moves forwards and then it turns right. So it's 0 to 90 degrees. So a place where air resistance would take a major part in would be in the book dominoes. With a larger surface area, there would be a larger air resistance on the books, on the dominoes. But if we decrease the air resistance or we decrease the surface area of the books, there would be less force that could be passed on to the other books, which would result in me not having enough force to push the football so that the cabinet would vibrate. So this is basically it for the final video of the Rube Goldberg machine. Thanks for watching.